First one that I thought of, comfortable shoes. Make sure you have very comfortable shoes, even if they cost a little more. I would really invest because Tijuana is a walking mission, and it has lots and lots and lots of hills. And so your feet will hurt every single day, and if you go more for style than for comfort, you probably will regret that. And as for clothing, I would get really lightweight, wrinkle-free clothing that's easy to take care of and wash. And really just, look nice but feel comfortable, because you will be, jumping on buses, and you will be walking around town all day. And sometimes you will be on a bike in other cities. As for, let's see, safety, I would just make sure you stay with your companion. The mission rules are there to protect us. And honestly, I didn't ever feel unsafe there. And so if you're in the lighted areas, if you're with, members, we always try to have a member present with us at night. You'll be fine. And I'd say really trust your mission president. If anything does happen, don't be afraid to just let him know, even if it was something that just scared you, because he and the sister, mission president, his wife, they are there to help you and to protect you as well. And so I really trusted in them and whatever guidance they gave us, even if it was go in a couple hours early today, we did it and we felt great. As for just well-being and health, I would exercise every single day. Even if your companion, doesn't do it as much, just getting moving in the morning, I really felt that helped me. And there were times when I did it more intensely than others, and that I really saw a difference when I did do that. And just be smart. See, the only thing that I thought of with awkward situations in Tijuana, in Mexico in general, they greet each other with a kiss on the cheek. And it doesn't matter which gender you are. And so lots of people, the members know that we don't hug the other gender, we don't do those things with the other gender. And so they don't come up to us and do that. But other people will. They'll come up and try to greet you with a kiss, or they're just very loving people, so they'll try to give you a hug. And you have to be kind of careful the way you deal with it, because you don't want to offend them by saying, don't hug me, you can't do that. But you have to let them know that, as missionaries, we don't do that. And we just try to stay away from those things for those 18 months or 2 years. And so I found myself in a couple awkward situations with things like that. But, if someone accidentally just hugs you, then you just, explain, sorry, I don't do that, and it'll be fine. But that was the only surprising thing that happened to me. While I was there, actually, they had us wear pants for 4 months, because the mosquitoes got so bad that I think in many different countries and missions, they had the sisters wear pants, because the mosquitoes were so bad that they were carrying viruses and things like that. And so to protect us, they had us cover up as much as we could. But no one in my mission got sick from it. And so that was kind of an interesting thing that we had to do to protect ourselves from sicknesses. But other than that, I think I just had the common cold once in a while, and that was fine.